Yeah, he brought a meal. You're enough to share with everyone now? I cut it off. The feeding of the 5,000, right? We did a team triathlon this weekend, and Dr. Chad came in top 100. He was 83rd. Age you are, you just keep going. That's really all there is to it. Just keep moving. That's what I just kept telling myself. Just keep moving, right? So the human mind is way more powerful than we ever give it credit for, and you're stronger than you would ever think as well. So I just wanted to give you that encouragement and also celebrate with Dr. Chad because he did an awesome job, and he did really good with it. He encouraged us all to join him in doing this, and so we did. It was a lot of fun. So. With that being said, we're going to kick off our medicine cabinet makeover here tonight. The point of this, and I just want to kind of set the stage for the discussion, because I don't want you to get in the mindset of we're just going to teach you to do a natural version for a symptomatic treatment. You understand what I'm saying by that? So if you would normally go to the medicine cabinet, if you're having a headache and grab an aspirin or something, I don't want this just to be like, okay, well, you grab the lavender instead. That's not the point. I still want us to be out of the mindset of treating symptoms. Now, is there a time when it's really helpful to have some symptomatic treatment that's not poisoning your body to help you get a real relief? As long as you understand the bigger picture, right? That's really what the goal is. So we're not moving away from the principle. We're going to talk about a lot of the different resources that we have. Has anyone walked into the office before and seen that huge supplement shelf and been a little overwhelmed by that? You can be honest, you know. There's a lot of stuff out there, right? And you may or may not know necessarily if you need any of it, if it could be beneficial for you, or even how to use it. So we're going to go through a lot of those things tonight. And most importantly, we're going to share with you what our medicine cabinets look like in our homes. I don't even call it the medicine cabinet. We call it the health cabinet. You know, and when I'm not feeling well, where do I go to get my health back? I go to the health cabinet, right? And, you know, overall, more oftentimes than not, I don't even have to go to the health cabinet because we're applying the five essentials model of care that we teach and that we teach you guys. And so, you know, we keep our bodies healthy and well. So many times my body will recover so quickly that I don't need to go there in the first place. Does that make sense? And so that would be the eventual goal, is that we're still focused on treating the cause, but it doesn't hurt to help advance the symptoms along the way so that you don't have to suffer as long. And I think, unfortunately, especially with the recent scene that we've seen socially and politically, I think we can agree we've all seen enough suffering over the past few weeks or past few months. Would you agree with me on that? And so our job is to eliminate, part of our mission statement is to eliminate unnecessary suffering. And we see a lot of unnecessary suffering right now in our world. And I believe that we're called, that I'm called as a Christian man to step into the gap and fill the needs of people so that we can help to eliminate some of that unnecessary suffering. Is that a mission you can get on board with me about? I think that's something that we could all get on board with. And really, it's pretty easy because who deserves health? How many people around you deserve to be healthy and deserve to be well? Do you think that's a fundamental human? You know, humans deserve to be healthy and well and try and reach their fullest potential, right? So this speaks just into the mission of who we are and what we do. So we believe that the body has the power and the capacity to heal itself. It doesn't need any help. It just needs no interference. And so we're going to get to the cause to remove the interference. And in the meantime, today we'll show you some things that will help with the symptoms while you are, in fact, addressing the cause. Does that make sense? Okay, so by no means is my expectation that you should go out and buy everything that I'm going to go through today. But at least you'll be educated on it. And that way, if the need arises in the future, you will know that the resource is available and hopefully you'll have some basic understanding of how to utilize it in a proper format. That's really the purpose of what this is about tonight, okay? So I'm not selling any supplements tonight. In fact, we didn't bring any of that stuff or anything. In fact, what we brought tonight was something to help you understand the mission even greater. So I think, you know, with the recent events, what I like to do when this stuff is happening in our world is to see what can we do to bring positivity and encouragement back to our society. I still believe in the human race, as I'm sure many of you do. I believe in the fundamental good of people, that they want to do good, they want to do right if given the opportunity. I still believe that. And I still believe inside of each and every one of us, we have a choice. And we can choose to do good or we can choose to do bad. And I would hope that you would choose to try and make a difference and try and do good with us. And so what we'll be doing throughout the next week is our Light Up Your Life event. And it's very simple. How many of you have seen these glow bracelets before? Right? They're fun. The kids love them. But to be honest, adults, they kind of like them too. I mean, they're fun at night. I mean, who doesn't like glow-in-the-dark stuff, right? So we'd like to give each one of you one of these to take with you to have fun with it, or give it to one of your kids or something like that. But then we would also like to give you another one to give to someone else that you know is suffering. And whether they're suffering from the loss of a close one, whether they're suffering emotionally, whether they're suffering physically, whether you think that we can help them or not, just a simple gift that you can give to them to give them a little hope. How cool is that? And to let them know that somebody in the world cares enough to at least be thinking about that for them. Okay, so we want to give you one. Feel free to take as many of these as you want. If you know a lot of people that are suffering right now, then take 10, take 20, however many you need, right? We want to do that as a gift into our community. And of course, it has the opportunity for them to see what we can do to help eliminate any unnecessary suffering. If you found the care beneficial, if you feel that we've done a good job for you and your family, I would hope that you would want to share that with someone else and help them eliminate unnecessary suffering as well. So the Light Up Your Life, make sure that you grab one of these on your way out, or two or ten or however many it is that you need. And if we run out, we'll have them in all of the offices throughout the entire week. So if you run into more people that need these things and you want to just be a little positive light of encouragement for them, then you can grab more in the office and give as many out as you feel that you can do. Agreed? All right, can you guys help me brighten up our world here a little bit this week? Would that be fun with our Light Up Your Life event? Thank you all for being willing to do that. So again, you know, getting back into what we do is our fundamentals is the five essentials. So essential number one is maximizing your mindset. Understand the principle that you were designed and created to heal and be well. Did you know that? You're created for health. God didn't make junk, right? Our bodies were created to be well. But the problem is that in modern day society, with the stress and the foods and the chemicals that we come in contact with, the way that our human frame and the structure gets damaged over time, then the body is no longer healthy. And it's not because it's not programmed or designed to be that way. Remember, your body doesn't need any help healing, it just needs no interference. All of those things interfere with proper functioning and health of the human body. And so our goal is to remove those interferences and restore your body back to healing and being well. Essential number one is just simply understanding that principle and then being willing to follow a process that aligns with that principle to the application of it. And that's what the next four essentials are. So essential number one is the understanding, the knowledge, and the actual application of that would be essential number two, which would be taking care of your nervous system through chiropractic care by doing your home rehabilitation. Essential number three would be maximizing your nutrition. So trying to eat clean foods, making sure that you're putting nutrients into your body, that your nutrient systems are absorbing things correctly. Essential number four would be your fitness essential, making sure that you're keeping up with your body, staying in shape, keeping your mobility so that you can have long-standing functional health and have the quality of life that we would all hope to have as we move into our 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s plus, however long the good Lord's going to keep us here for, right? And essential number five is minimizing toxicity. So drawing the toxins out of the body, minimizing our exposure to as many environmental toxins as we can control so that our body can, again, just function and heal the way that it's designed and created without that toxic interference. Okay, get the concept, right? All right, so that's the basis of the cause, of getting to the cause. So moving into some more of the symptomatic stuff that we can do to help. Now, how many of you open up the medicine cabinet and it kind of looks a little like this? Or maybe it used to at some point. Nobody wants to admit it now, right? No, I don't want to see that, right? But did any of these look familiar? Everybody's seen these before, right? You got the Pepto-Bismol, right? You got Clearasil for the acne or the face stuff. Benadryl, if you have a food response or a food allergy, right? If puffy, swollen. I think I even saw some 5-hour energy drink up there. I don't know why that's in the medicine cabinet, but it's in there. Some Selsun and Blue, some Tums, right? So, what we're gonna try and help you do is shift your medicine cabinet from looking like this, because when I see this, you know what I see? I see more interference. That's what I see. Because every time you have to pull something from one of those shelves and put it in your body because you feel that it's a symptomatic need, then it's really just adding to the toxicity exposure. Agreed? And so it may seem like you don't have to use that very often, but I bet you if you journaled it and tracked it, you would find yourself going into the toxic medicine cabinet a lot more than you would really appreciate for your body. And the accumulation that has over time is really what we're trying to reduce and help you to be able to capitalize on a better version of this. So let's shift our medicine cabinet into a health cabinet, right? It should look more like something like this, okay? So we'll walk through specific products and things that we utilize in here, but there's also some very simple, basic, fundamental stuff that's not even in the medicine cabinet that's also very advantageous for simple home remedy treatment that can be very powerful and very effective for helping you actually be well. So this is the direction that we're moving in, right? The other cool thing is that what I recognize is that as busy as our offices are, we'll have patients come in and they need help with something. They're like, "Doc, I got snivels, I feel like I have the flu or a cold or something like that. What should I do? Like, I see you have all these amazing supplements. There's probably something over there that can help me. What should I do?" Right, Chris? You've done this before. And I'll rattle off like 4 or 5 things real quick. Do this, do this, do this, do this. Because, we don't have a specific consult schedule, but I still want to help you, and get you moving in the right direction. Well, what we've done to help overcome that is we've created these little cards. So this one literally says, "Sick, do this." And then it lists out exactly the things that I typically will rattle off to a patient, right? So those of you that have been ill before in my office and have gone through this protocol, what is it that I'll typically rattle off? What are some of the things that I'll tell you to do when you're sick? Yeah, a little silver could be one of them. What's another one?
Vitamin C.
Vitamin C, vitamin D, I heard as well. What else?
Greens.
The greens, absolutely. What about other functional lifestyle changes? What else should you be doing? Sleep. Cut the what? Cut what? Cut the sugar. Absolutely. What does sugar do to your immune system? Yeah, sugar lowers your immune system, right? What else do we recommend? Cut the breads, the grains, the pastas, the rices for that period of time. Make sure that you're hydrated, drinking plenty of water, right? So those are all good things that can help your body heal through the illness or the virus. So we've actually put those recommendations now onto a simple card. These will be on our website so you can access them immediately or whenever you want, but we'll also have these in the adjusting bay. So if you come in there and you're like, "Doc, I'm sick and I'm not feeling well, what should I do?" I can pull a card off and do this or circle specific things on it for you and then give that to you right away as a resource so you know exactly how to do it, right? Because I'll tell a patient to go take vitamin D and they'll go and they'll take one capsule of vitamin D and think that that's gonna help, right? So he's like, "I did that, yeah." And then she'll be like, I'm doing it. And I'll be like, or she'll come back and say, "I did it, but it didn't work." And I'll be like, "Well, how much vitamin D were you taking?" "Well, I was taking one capsule." When you're ill, your body needs a lot more vitamin D. So I will actually take 50,000 units of vitamin D when I feel sickness coming on, because literally, if I do that first thing in the morning, if I have a sniffly nose, and I hit the vitamin D and the vitamin C in this protocol that I'm showing you, by the afternoon, I will have no symptoms. It's already gone. Whereas you guys may struggle with a week or two with it, I have a half a day. Okay, so to me, that time is so valuable for me to be able to stay in the office and continue to interact with you and take care of you and do the things that I need to do on a weekly basis, that I will hit 50,000 units of vitamin D, I'll do 4,000 units or 4,000 milligrams of vitamin C, maybe multiple times a day. I will do colloidal silver if I feel that I need it, but I'll also do some of these protocols right here. So what you'll see is we also have the gold product. The gold product is specifically designed more on the bacterial side. So if you have a bacterial infection, you want to take the gold. The gold's specifically designed to boost your immune system. Right here, you probably can't see it, but right below gold, it says Immune Plus. So it's designed to boost your immune system, and the supplement shelves are labeled now. Have you guys noticed that? So we have them labeled for like heart, immune system. So this one's under the immune system section. We have them labeled for pain. We have them, you know, labeled for all kinds of different categories. So if you look under that category listing there, that can kind of help guide and direct you. And then you just look in the supplements that are on that part of the shelf, right? So the gold is specifically to help for a general infection or a bacterial infection. The Vivi, what do you think that one's for? Virus, you got it. So that's a virus. That's going to help kick a virus. So it stimulates the parts of the immune system that help you fight off a virus. And those do work really, really well. If you have a very strong bacterial infection, something that you would have normally considered taking an antibiotic for, how many of you were at last month's workshop where we talked about the A-bomb, antibiotics, and how much that destroys the digestive system? So our goal would be not to have you do an antibiotic, but if you had an infection that was that significant that you would otherwise feel the need to do that, then what we have patients do is the silver, the ACS 200. And what that is it's colloidal silver. It's as powerful as an antibiotic without destroying the gut bacteria to the same degree. So I don't recommend that patients do that as an automatic necessarily, unless we feel that you have a really strong infection that you need to fight off. But we will have you do that in the cases where it's severe enough. You know, we want to make sure that we kick it, you know, kick it hard, kick it fast, and make sure that we get you back up to speed, and then we can have you do the silver. Now, if you're going to do the silver, then what else would you need to do to replenish the healthy gut bacteria? Yeah, you should do the probiotics, and you should also do probiotics if you do ever find yourself in the need, because we're, you know, let's be honest, at some point in your life, you may have a crisis or emergency need for an antibiotic, right? That's what it's there for. Really, that should only be maybe 3 or 4 times in our entire life that we would actually need that level of an intervention. Does that make sense? Okay, if you would ever find yourself in that position, also you would want to make sure that you take probiotics in the same capacity, in the same time frame. And this has actually changed from what I previously understood. Normally, I would have you do the antibiotic or the silver without doing the probiotics. What we found is that if you take them in combo, it helps your digestive system recover so much faster afterwards. So we'll actually have you take them through the process of recovering from that illness, okay? And then, you know, the C, the vitamin C that we use, you really want to get your vitamin C levels to saturation when you're ill. Does anyone know what that means? You basically will take 1,000 milligrams every 15 to 30 minutes until it comes out the other end. Okay, until you have loose stools. And that tells me that you've reached your saturation point, and then you're gonna back it off, and you know that that's your saturation point for what you can actually handle if you were to ever have another health issue, you know, crop up in the future. So for most patients, that's usually around 5,000 to 6,000 milligrams. So I conservatively will recommend that they do 4,000 milligrams a day if they're fighting off an illness, and that way they won't have bowel flush with it. But you would really want to test it for yourself to see what your saturation point is. I know Dr. Nick, who's one of our doctors in the other office at the Waukesha Clinic, his saturation point is like 1 gram per day. So he can do, or excuse me, 10 grams per day, sorry. So that's 10,000 milligrams of vitamin C per day. So that's well beyond most people's bowel tolerance to be able to do that. But he's had to build up to that level get there. So you can build your vitamin C levels also. It's not necessarily a bad idea. So okay, so when you're sick, what are you going to do? You're going to do this, right? There is a quiz later, so keep some of these. I see some of you out there taking notes. So Dr. Asher is going to come and do the here, the ACS 200. It does come in two different formats. It comes in the spray, and the way that this is best worked is it is when it's activated through your lymphatic system. So the way that you'll use it is you'll spray it under your tongue. You use 6 to 10 sprays, you know, a half dozen or so to a dozen sprays, on directly under the tongue, and then you're gonna swish for 30 seconds. You're gonna swish for 30 seconds, gargle for 30 seconds, and then swallow. And that really helps to activate the lymphatics. The lymphatic system is your first line of defense for your immunity. So it activates your immune system processes. And so that's the reason why we'll have you do that. Okay, so then you'll do that protocol, 6 to 10, squirts directly under the tongue, swish, gargle, swallow, and we'll have you do that 3 to 4 times a day as long as the infection persists. And so again, that's if you were having, you know, a bacterial infection that you would have otherwise taken an antibiotic for. The other version of that is the nasal. So if you get really bad sinus infections or really bad allergies that you can't seem to kick without an antibiotic, then this would be the way to go for that. So obviously the nasal version, just like you would use any other nasal applicant, you're going to breathe through the application of it, get it up into the sinuses and the nasal cavities, and then let it drain out. And what that silver does, the mechanism that it works, the silver actually attaches to the wall of the bacterial cell and it disintegrates it. So it kills the bacteria by exposing it, basically opens up all its parts. And so it can't survive like that anymore. And so that's the way that it works. But it really has very little, if any, harm to the human cells, because it's in the colloidal version, it just passes right through our body. It can't be digested or absorbed. So you know, that's the advantage of that. 3 to 4 times a day. And then the other one that I wanted to have a little special focus on today is curcumin. And how many of you have heard about turmeric or the benefits of curcumin or turmeric, something like that? Yeah, it's been a big, huge hit in a lot of news and media outlets lately, but they really only give you half the story. So if you were, you know, typical, right? If you were to go and do the turmeric route, great, that's fine. But number one, turmeric is extremely difficult for your body to absorb. In fact, black pepper increases the absorbability of turmeric root extract 20-fold. Okay, so you almost have to consume it in combination with black pepper in order for it to even be minimally effective in that format, okay? The second part of it is that they don't tell you about it is that the active part that actually does something for you is called curcumin. And you would have to eat like, you know, if you've ever looked at a spice bottle of turmeric, right? You would have to eat like 10 of those bottles to get the effects of one capsule in this bottle of concentrated curcumin. So it literally creates a potency that can't be matched just by eating turmeric. So am I saying don't eat turmeric? No, absolutely not. Obviously, any of it that you can get in is going to be some benefit to you. But if you truly want the anti-inflammatory benefits and the benefits against dementia and Alzheimer's and sugar metabolism and all the things that cancer benefits, all the things that you read about in those research articles and in the media outlets, then you really need to be taking the turmeric extract, which is called curcumin, and you should even be taking that in combination with black pepper. Does that make sense? Okay? So, yeah, just regular black pepper, just like you would put on your eggs or, you know, whatever else to season food. So just your standard black pepper.
So are these capsules?
Those are capsules.
So you take a capsule, how do you get the black pepper?
So you can either eat the black pepper in your meal, that you can sprinkle some in your water as you're down in your capsules. Any way that you can get the black pepper in, then you can palate.
How much do you need?
It doesn't have to be much, just enough to activate the ingredients in here. So just a dash or a sprinkle of it, it's fine.
Perfect.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be a ton.
Is this a daily thing that you
do? Yeah. Especially if you're looking to get the anti-inflammatory benefits, then you would apply the curcumin and the black pepper. I usually, if, you know, on days that I'm doing this, I will usually do it with a meal, and like I, you know, mentioned to you, I just sprinkle black pepper on eggs or something like that, and just take the curcumin right before the meals, and then eat the black pepper with, you know, eat my eggs with sea salt and black pepper on them, and then I get it in there, and it's all good to go. So, yeah, this is a great ibuprofen alternative, so it's an amazing anti-inflammatory. So if you have a sports injury or a trip and fall or headaches or, you know, other things like that where you would want to symptomatically and acutely treat an injury of acute inflammation, this is amazing for that, but it's also very good for chronic systemic inflammatory conditions as well, like arthritis and depression, cancer, and it's a great antioxidant as well. So that's what helps to protect the cell and keep them healthy and keep them young and keep them functioning correctly. So there was a seminar that Dr. Chad went to where it was like a 15-hour seminar, and the guy's response to every single condition that he went through had curcumin in it. Because it's just that powerful of a nutrient. So I wanted to spend just a couple minutes on that so you guys knew how to properly take it, because I don't want you to take something and not get the benefits from it, right? And that's what happens when people will take supplements for a while, and you want to make sure you're getting a quality version. That's another great conversation for us to have. So you could go and take the theory of what I'm teaching tonight, but if you go buy all Walgreens brand or Walmart brand or even GNC brand for that matter supplements, you won't still get the same benefit, because oftentimes, if you don't know how to read ingredients, you're likely picking up stuff that has a bunch of preservatives and fillers and things like that. And for those of you that we've sat down and done a supplement review, right, and it, literally people will bring in garbage bags full of supplements into the office, and we'll go through them one by one and show them which ones are good for them to still consider taking and which ones they absolutely need to replace. And they're always surprised by how many they need to throw in the trash because they're just no good, right? And so, you know, I want you to get a quality supplement. The cheapest version of a supplement is the one that actually does the job. Isn't that true? Otherwise, you're just throwing your money down the drain with it, right? Yes. No, I think that's just the brand. Yeah, that's just part of the brand. Yeah, it's the curcumin phytozone. Curcumin is really the active ingredient. That's what
you're
talking about.
One good question. So, you're kind of an all time pills every day?
Yeah, absolutely. Great anti-inflammatory property. One a day would do the trick. Yeah, if you have active chronic inflammation, 2 to 3 a day. Yeah, but one a day would be a great maintenance dose. Absolutely. Yes,
how often do you take the other one? You get switched every day.
Which one?
That one.
This one?
No, the other one.
The curcumin? Mm-hmm. That's what this gentleman just asked. As a maintenance dose, you can take one capsule a day just to keep the anti-inflammatory properties. If you were actively fighting one of these conditions or chronic inflammation, 2 to 3 capsules a day would be recommended. Okay? And of course, that can vary depending on your specific case or condition. Myself or Kieran can walk you through that. So, you know, don't be afraid to talk to one of our team members. We're always, you know, going to help you guys figure that kind of stuff out if you need it. All right, here's the can't sleep formula, right? So a couple different ones here. This is probably the second most common symptom that I get asked about. Doc, I'm having difficulty sleeping. What can I do to help with a better quality night's sleep? Or what can I do to get better quantity sleep? So whether it's a quantity or a quality issue, that will actually change the protocol that I'll put together for you. So I almost always ask that question. So how do you know the difference? Well, a quantity issue is if you're just plain not sleeping, right? If you're only getting 2 to 3 hours of sleep, you're not getting enough sleep overall. You need to be getting at least 7 to 8 hours of quality sleep each night, okay? A quality issue is you're sleeping 7 to 8 hours, but it's not quality sleep. Does that make sense? So you're waking up frequently, whether it's to go to the bathroom or your mind's cranking, or you're in pain, you know, whatever the case is, it's interrupted sleep. And you're not therefore getting the deep cycles of REM and non-REM sleep that you really need to refresh the brain, reset, and actually heal. Your body does the most healing during the sleep process. So I always tell patients, if you're not sleeping, you are not healing. So sleep is extremely important. There's a couple tips on here that I'm going to give you that are freebie tips. If you're the type of sleeper that your mind's cranking and that's what doesn't let you sleep, I want you to get in the habit of putting a journal on the nightstand. And when you find yourself awake and the mind's just turning and churning and turning, pull out the journal, take the 5 minutes to jot down the thoughts of your mind, and that lets you empty the brain. You can get back to them in the morning, but at least then it allows you to get a good night's rest. Okay? okay? Just to make a quick, simple bullet point list is sometimes all a patient needs to have some effective results with that. So empty the mind. Make sure you have the temperature right. The colder the better is kind of the rule of thumb, but too warm is not good. But really, you know, 70 to 73 degrees is really the ideal room temperature at night for sleeping. And that has to do with the way that your body's core temperature changes when you go from a vertical position to a horizontal position. Okay, when you go horizontal, blood flows out to the extremities, your core temperature cools down, and so we want to mimic that cooling of the core temperature, and that's been shown to help people get better quality night's rest during the night. So if you're having difficulty with quality, you may need to address the temperature of the room. And then finally, a completely dark room. And this is an often overlooked one, but even if you have light coming through the slits of the blinds, or if you have bright electronics like a bright alarm clock in the room, that can constantly stimulate your receptors of that interrupts with your melatonin production, and you'll never get a good night's sleep because of that. One of the biggest ones that we find is harmful is blue light. Blue light comes from electronics, so looking at your cell phone or an iPad, computer, or watching the TV right before bedtime is also ill-advised because it messes with the melatonin receptors again in the brain. Okay, so you want to cut those things off half hour, 45 minutes, even an hour before bedtime, especially if you're not sleeping well. I would even recommend up to 2 hours before bedtime. Cut off the electronics, read a book instead, check out, journal if you got to do your journaling, you know, do your nighttime routine to get your body to relax a little bit. And if you need to, you can use some of these other things as well. So if you're not having good quality sleep, I recommend the DREM. The DREM contains tryptophan and melatonin. So this one I don't like to keep patients on for very long. I don't want your body to get addicted to melatonin replacement. But if you're not having good quality sleep, to help reset those hormonal cycles and get you sleeping better, this can be a good short-term product. The other one is more for either quantity or more of a long-term sleep help aid, the sleep and mood formula. And this one is not the direct hormones themselves, it's the precursors. So the advantage to that is your body will only use the precursors as it needs them, right? So it doesn't have as dramatic or immediate of an effect. It's more of a long-term solution to the problem. And then if you're having achy joints or pain, what I recommend, or if you're just plain having problems relaxing before bed, just tense, tight, just really can't get into a calm, rested state, use the magnesium gel. The magnesium gel is amazing for that. Magnesium has a natural calming effect on the body, and especially on the nerves of the body. If you just take a little dabble of that magnesium gel and rub it all over your abdomen, it's amazing how much that just, because it gets absorbed directly into the bloodstream that way. So the advantage over taking oral magnesium, most oral magnesium is not absorbed through the digestive system very well unless it's taken in combination with some of the other minerals like calcium. You ever heard of a CalMag supplement? That's why they pair them like that, right? So this way you can get just the magnesium directly into the bloodstream because it gets absorbed right through the skin and it goes right into the bloodstream. It's also great for treating an affected area. So say, for example, you did a triathlon this weekend, right? And you had some cramping or soreness that night. Or if you're getting restless leg or things like that, you can take a dabble of the magnesium gel and rub that on the affected area that's sore. Or if you have a sore spot on your back that's keeping you up, rub it directly in that area. It will help to calm and relax that area, which will help you to get a better night's sleep as well. Okay? Everybody's going to be sleeping good tonight? Peter?
I don't have trouble falling asleep, but I'll sleep for 4 or 5 hours and then I have to go to the bathroom.
Sure.
And then I have trouble falling back to sleep.
Back to sleep after that.
Yeah. And then I found two, the high dose B complex.
Yeah.
I don't, do B vitamins give you energy?
Yes. B.
I have trouble sleeping if I take the high dose B complex.
Yes. B vitamins are critical in the energy production cycle. If your body's producing energy in a healthy manner, it shouldn't impact your sleep too much. But what that shows me, Peter, is that you get up, your adrenal glands get going again, and then they won't settle back down. So you would really need either the sleep and mood formula would be best for you, or we have another product called the Adrenal Calm that I will also recommend for cases specific like that. Because essentially you get up, you go to the bathroom, and your blood flow gets going again. When, as soon as those adrenals kick back up and it gets your body systems going, you can't calm back down soon enough to get back to sleep before the alarm's going off again. And that's what's happening. So taking some Adrenal Calm either right before bedtime or right when you got up to do, you know, do the bathroom stuff, and then on the way back you get some Adrenal Calm, and then that should help to calm things down within half hour, 45 minutes to get you back to sleep again. Yes, ma'am.
Either of those, or any of those three, which would you use to shut your mind
out? I don't know if there's one specifically to do that. That would really be more the journaling. So if your mind's cranking, I would recommend the journaling would be the best thing to empty the mind to do that. Yeah, unfortunately it's tough to shut our brain down, but sometimes we wish we could all do that, you know, when things get tough. So I'm happy to field questions, but let's wait till afterwards, otherwise there's no way we'll get through all the material tonight in a timely manner, right? Another little special focus here, lavender oil. This is also very calming. It's great for sunburns and wounds. It does also help to improve sleep, so that's why I threw it in there. There's a lot of great essential oils and great benefits to essential oils, but I think lavender is probably one of the most diverse and is one of the staples that we keep in our health cabinet because it's my go-to oil. If I got something going on and I don't know what the best thing is for it, I usually turn to coconut oil and lavender oil. Do a little mix of those and put it on, right? So if it's a rash or a bump or something, a bruise, whatever it is, so lavender oil is great for that kind of stuff. Here's one for the weight loss jump start. This is also an extremely common one that I'll get. Mary, quick question.
Yeah, lavender.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, because those are actually the oils that make the scent. So you're going to get a very low intensity of them. Obviously, the oil is the much more concentrated form where you're going to get a lot higher volume of that. But yeah, absolutely. In fact, a lot of people will put oils into a diffuser and they'll diffuse them throughout the room, and you can utilize them that way to get the benefit as well. So inhaling is as beneficial as using it as a topical, and it's still being ingested. It goes through your lungs that way. Okay, weight loss jump starts. Couple things here. One of the things that we find that's really tough for patients if they're having weight loss resistance is it usually has to do with the fact that there are some toxins that their body isn't processing through. And if you're not aware of what toxins do in the weight loss process, toxins are mostly fat soluble. And so they will bind to the fat, the adipose tissue inside of our bodies. Your body uses that as a protective mechanism. So it will not burn that particular fat off until the toxins are removed first. Does that make sense? And so that's a protective mechanism that keeps the body from burning that fat. So if you hit a weight loss resistance, you may need to hit the detox hard again. I recommend that if you've done the maximized living version of it and you've tolerated that well, we have a stronger version of detox that we've made available as well now, which is the G cell in the bind. It operates on the same principle. It pulls toxins out of the cell, increases your intracellular glutathione, which is your body's most powerful antioxidant for eliminating toxins. And then the bind is what binds the toxins for elimination within the bowels and removes them through the stool. Okay, that's the safest way to detoxify the body without having other harmful effects. I've had patients say, well, you could do cilantro and things like that to detox metals. Yes, you can. Those only have two binding sites for the metal, whereas this has four binding sites. Plus, this is a much concentrated format. You would have to eat cilantro almost all day, every day, to get anywhere close to the benefit of even one capsule of what you would do with the bind. So, I would definitely recommend, for a more intense version to do that. It has the dosing recommendations and everything right on the card here. Again, those will be posted on the website. Another great one would be the Max Fit. The Max Fit helps to calm cortisol levels. So I also recommend this one frequently for patients that are experiencing higher periods of stress in their life. Cortisol runs rampant with stress. That also creates weight loss resistant. It creates a hormonal cascade that can be very disruptive for brain fog and thinking and mental clarity, but also can be really difficult in keeping other hormones in balance as well. So it kind of throws everything off. So the MaxFit has a lot of adaptogenic herbs inside of it, and those are just what they sound like. They help your body adapt to stress. And specifically, they do that by pushing down the cortisol levels. So then that also helps you be able to release the hormones necessary to lose weight again. The carnitine, pro-L-carnitine, is it's a fat burner. It just stimulates fat burning inside of your body. So if you're looking to accelerate the weight loss, melt the fat off, the L-carnitine is a good one to do for that. And then also on the website, it's mentioned here on the card, Dr. Nick has put together a Max Health Shake here for you. So we're gonna watch that video really quick.
Hi, this is Dr. Nick Ellenson from Max Health Chiropractic. Today I wanna walk you through the Max Health Shake. This is one of my favorite shakes for a post-workout recovery drink. You can use this as a meal replacement. So it's a very versatile shake. It's very easy to make. So we've got a couple different things here. We've got some whey, grass-fed whey protein for maximized living. It's an excellent source for protein. The proteins have not been denatured because it is a low temperature processing. It's also a very good quality because it does come from grass-fed cows. The other thing that we have is we have some greens. So we have the Max Health Greens. So this is an excellent source of vitamins, minerals, just to help to recover from exercise. So we have a few different flavors here. So we have strawberry, kiwi, we've got natural berry, we've got espresso for coffee lovers, and then we have my personal favorite, the chocolate. So today I'm gonna be making my favorite, which is the chocolate Max Health shake here. So what I'm gonna do is take a scoop of the grass-fed whey protein. Gonna take a scoop of the Max Health Greens. And then I'm also gonna be adding some MCT oil. So MCT oil is from coconuts. It's the medium chains that have been removed from it. So there's long chains, medium chains, and short chains. It is just the short chains. Excellent source of fat and excellent source of energy. So you can get real specific with this. I've been using this for quite a while. So if you've never used this before, you want to start slow. If you do a little bit too much too fast, you can have what I call disaster pants. So you definitely want to start slow with this, but like I said, I've been doing this for quite a while, so I'm just going to pour. If you're just starting out, start with a teaspoon or less, building up to about a tablespoon. The other thing that I'm going to be adding is some chia seeds. So I got some organic chia seeds. I think I got these from Sam's Club. I'm just going to be adding a tablespoon of those. And then that's all the ingredients. I've got some water here in my blender bottle, and then all you have to do is just give it a nice shake and you're ready to go. So it's a tasty treat that you can use as post-recovery. You can use this as a meal replacer. So my name is Dr. Nick Ellenson from Max Health Chiropractic, and have a great day. That's good.
Healthy hormones. This is another very common one that we'll get requests on, is how to balance out the hormones. To be honest, the hormonal issues are a little more complicated than just throwing some supplements at it. If you have hormonal issues, we really need to do the metabolics testing to figure out how to best customize the protocol for you. But if you have financial limitations or you can't fully commit to that yet, here's a couple things that you can do to get started on those. I would say the biggest one, and again, it depends on what you're dealing with, but the biggest one that I see in most patients is adrenal issues. Stressed out, running ragged, busy lifestyles, and it just runs the adrenal glands ragged. So if you're having energy issues, again, that could cause sleep issues like we discussed with Peter. If you just feel fatigued or you don't have any get up and go anymore in your step, your adrenal glands are likely suffering. So there's two different versions of the product that we use for that. One is an adrenal calm and one is an adrenal energy. So the adrenal calm is for somebody that's in adrenal fatigue. So there's two different levels of adrenal dysfunction. The first layer of that would be adrenal fatigue. And this is where your adrenal glands are still functioning. They're just not functioning at a high enough level because they're starting to fatigue. They're starting to get tired of the daily grind, right? If you continue on that course and don't address the issue, whether it's removing the stress and getting more rest or creating a healthier, less busy lifestyle, or if you don't address that, then you'll eventually go into another layer, a deeper level of dysfunction, which is called adrenal exhaustion. Once you reach the levels of adrenal exhaustion, I've had patients where it can take up to 2 to 3 years for them to restore their adrenal function back. So do not let your body get into adrenal function. That's really tough to bounce back from. It can be done, but it takes a lot of persistence in patients and consistency with the protocols to restore it. There's one critical nutrient that your adrenals need to function correctly. We've talked about this vitamin already. Does anybody know what it is?
Vitamin D.
Vitamin C, actually. Vitamin C, and vitamin D is in there too, but vitamin C is absolutely critical for the adrenal glands to be able to produce the hormones that they need to for your adrenals to function correctly. So adrenal calm is for somebody that's in adrenal fatigue. Adrenals go into fatigue and they start becoming dysfunctional. They send out energy signals that are just off the charts, and typically a patient will actually feel more charged at this time. They feel what they describe as wired and tired. So they're wired yet tired at the same time. You ever been there before?
Yep.
Yeah, absolutely. We've all been there at some point. So the adrenal calm helps to facilitate healing through that. The adrenal energy can help get things charged back up again when you need the little boost, but really you should be more consistently focused on the adrenal calm. If you get to the point of adrenal exhaustion, that's where you're just tired and tired. There is no wire. There's no energy. There's no extra in the tank. You know, if you were to try and do a 5K or triathlon or something like that, it would just put you down in the bed for a week. It would be so tough to recover and get your energy levels back. It usually affects people's sleep, so they're tired, but they can't sleep. That's like the worst of both ends, right? So the adrenal energy is very restorative for that. But many times what we'll find is that an underlying issue in the hormonal process is that your body's not methylating correctly. And that's a whole nother workshop that we can get into. But methylation is critical for your body to actually use the nutrients correctly to actually regulate, upregulate, turn on and off the gene structure of your body. That's what methylation is for, right? And so the Moore's product actually helps us to be able to get better methylation. So going a little off topic, a lot of times, you know, if I hear a patient complaining of allergies or the allergies kick up in there, people that have allergies typically have methylation issues. So it's, you know, when we test their metabolics, it will come back. Almost every time we'll have to put them on a methylator. If you have allergies, methylation is going to be one of the keys most likely. The other thing that you're probably going to need is something that will help push down the histamine levels. Histamine is another, you know, one of those transmitters that it has rampant effects on the body. It causes inflammations. You know what causes that itchiness on the nose when you feel like you're about to sneeze? That's a histamine response, okay? So every one of us has experienced that before. ACX is another product that we carry that actually helps to push down the histamine levels in the liver. So, you know, just to help go through the allergy stuff. But we have stuff for thyroid. We have stuff for you know, balancing out the inflammation, which is also critical for hormones. So that would be the optimal omega. But to be honest, you know, again, the hormones really need to be tested. It's a much more complicated issue than just throwing a supplement or something at it. So high blood pressure, this one's a little bit more straightforward. You know, number one, I always recommend that we check the atlas. The atlas is one of the most common misaligned structures that will create blood pressure issues, especially if they're chronic blood pressure issues for a patient. Beyond that, CoQ10 is absolutely critical, especially if you've already been placed on a statin medication. But especially your cardiovascular tissue needs CoQ10 to produce the proper energy and to be able to heal correctly. So CoQ10 is critical for that. The HCV is a heart product that specifically targets the vessels and the linings of a cardiovascular system. So if you've had chronic blood pressure issues, guess what's happened to your vessels over time? They've been stretched and dilated and worn out. You need to get the vessels healing correctly so they can respond. The elasticity can be restored correctly. That's what the HCV product is designed to help do, is to restore that. And again, magnesium also has a calming effect on the body, which can lower the blood pressure, so the magnesium gel can be helpful for that also. And then we have a couple other things in here, like lavender oil, again, has the calming effect. Reducing your caffeine intake can also spike blood pressure and cause chronic blood pressure issues. And then reducing your body's overall weight is also another critical one. So those are all on the card as well. Energy. Everybody loves to have great levels of energy so you can do the things that you want to do. Nobody likes to hit that 2 or 3 o'clock, you know, train wreck that can sometimes happen. You hit the energy wall, right? So there's a couple specific products that we have. This one over here in the corner is actually named Energy, so it kind of gives it away what it's for, right? It's not instant energy like a 5-hour energy drink. What it does is it actually helps to heal the body's internal energy production systems. So it's really more of a product for the long haul, something that you would take over the course of, say, a couple of months that will give your body restorative and recuperative energy. It's not something that you have to take ongoing forever, but it's not something like, oh, I need energy, I'm going to take a couple capsules and now my energy's better, right? It's something that you're actually, you know, working with your body's system to get better energy production. Magnesium is also one of the key deficiencies. 80% of people tested are deficient in magnesium. That's what the research and surveys tell us overall. So there's a lot of people that are deficient in magnesium that need to be taking it. Not only, again, is it great for calming the nervous system and the muscles, but it is needed for energy production as well. So the greens, which are loaded with good B vitamin and enzyme structure, so that's very energizing. And then Peter already mentioned how B complex is critical in the energy production systems as well. So any one of those or more could be part of the issue. And then if we apply those protocols and we're still not getting the effects that we want, then we should get thyroid testing done and see if the thyroid is not producing thyroxine correctly. That can also throw off your energy metabolism and your overall destroy your weight loss efforts as well. So again, you know, the thyroid could be part of it. But then we also learned from last workshop that if you have a disrupted gut, that can also affect what? That can affect the thyroid. So it really is about taking care of the whole body. Because the more and more that you study this, you find out that it's all connected one level or another, right? Whether it's through the nervous system, through the digestive systems, whether it's through the hormonal systems, they all have to work and coordinate together. So that's why a lot of our recommendations always turn back to the everyday essentials, which is, you know, taking care of the body, just the fundamentals, right? I like the KISS theory. Keep it simple, right? That's the way to go. So if you need a snack, we have a couple different versions of healthy snack options in the energy bars, portable, make it really easy. You know what is another great portable snack option? Fruit, right? That's why God put a peel on a banana or a peel on the orange, right? He made it portable for us. You can already take it with you, just grab it and go. You can peel it on the road, right? Men's and women's Maltese, I would recommend if there was one supplement that you could only afford to do one and only one, vitamin D3 is the one that you absolutely have to go with. Well, why would you say that, Dr. Frahm? You know, most people can get vitamin D free from the sun. That is true, but do you know what, again, they only tell you half the story, right? How do you actually get that? You have to have torso exposure, right? So for women, you know, bikini exposure in the sun. For men, shirt off exposure, because this is where the majority of vitamin D production actually comes from. Did you know that? So if you're just going and getting face or arm exposure for the recommended 15 or 20 minutes is what they tell you, 15 to 20 minutes of sun exposure. But you can't do that on just these little small parts of the body and actually expect that your body's going to have adequate vitamin D production. It would have to be 15 to 20 minutes of full torso or upper thigh exposure is where the highest levels of vitamin D production are done. So guys, get the Speedos out for the summer, right? Water. Yeah, or that's why I say, you know, especially in Wisconsin, for half the year the sun's not even out, right? And we have had a really amazing summer, agreed? It's been really awesome. We've had a lot of great sunshiny days. That helps, but I guarantee you that if you actually got a blood draw and tested the vitamin D3, even with the extra sun exposure, the levels are still probably not adequate in that ideal range. We want them in that 70 to 90 range, right? So more on the upper scale of what the medical doctors recommend. They only care if it's above 30. So if you're between 30 and 70, you're really not getting the benefits of vitamin D the way that, that you should have it. So you really want it in the upper scale of the 70 to 90. But then some other, you know, ones would be your protein, your greens, your probiotics, your healthy fats and your omegas. These are all critical for reducing inflammation, facilitating proper hormonal and or nerve system function, and creating a healthy overall body. That's why they're called the everyday essentials, right? Okay, I'm done jabbing at y'all. We're gonna bring up Dr. Asha, and she's gonna finish us off here tonight. So if you would, help me bring up Dr. Asha. All right.
Hey everybody, it's nice to meet you. Like I said, I'm Dr. Asha. So I'm gonna be going over some homeopathic remedies for you. So a lot of the other stuff that he covered tonight, we do have available in the office. This stuff we don't have available in the office, but it's good to have in hand, like I said, kind of a first aid kit to have at home. And any of this stuff can be available at Vitamin Shop or GNC. So starting off, we're going with Arnica. Arnica is one of my favorite, and I use it. I've been an athlete for many years. The team convinced me to do the triathlon yesterday, which was great, but Arnica has been my best friend today. Arnica is used for sore muscles, any swelling, bruises, bumps. It's the go-to for that. It's great. It comes in two different forms. So it can come in something that you take orally, so it's a tablet, where you'll either dissolve it under your tongue, or you can chew it and swallow it, or it'll come in a gel or a cream. So I love this for bruises. So as soon as you get a bruise right away, it happens to everyone, you trip, you fall, get a little bump or a bruise, go ahead and put the Arnica on there right away, and it'll help it clear up faster, and usually it reduces the severity of the bruising as well. Who have menstrual pain. So the good news is that it's a group quiz. It's not individual, so I'm just going to have you guys kind of shout out answers with me and go through. And you won't be graded, so no stress. It's the best kind of quiz. All right. So this looks pretty gross. What is this? Pink eye. Yes. So now, what would you do if you got pink eye or your young one had pink eye? Colloidal silver. Silver, yes. Exactly. Right there? Yeah, you can do the colloidal silver if it's specifically for the pink eye. So we have it in the spray, we have it in the nasal spray, and you also can get it in with a dropper, and you can put it directly in your eye. This works great. So I know Dr. Frahm was telling me, I personally never used it for pink eye, but he said it works instantly, pretty much, where if it happens, get it in there right away, and hopefully the kids won't even have to miss school or anything. Yep, because it's natural antibiotic and anti-infective. It's going to help clean it out and take care of everything.
Sometimes that happens if you're taking too much of a supplement. My eye kind of does that.
Really?
So I do the same thing for that.
Yeah, I think it can help clear it out. I have the colloidal silver. If it's not an infection,
you guys.
guys all passed. Nice job. So this is something that's been in the media.